IGs.
And
turn
we
to
are
ban.
Back with game two.
Tongfu versus IG. IG.
Quiet, announcer. I'm talking. Tongfu versus IG, game two. And I want to give a special thank you to you guys. Because, so, after the game finished up, we had the stream drop a little bit, right? And I went back, and apparently, I looked at my Twitch screen right after the stream had dropped. So I look over and I see 757 viewers. And I was like, oh, man. Today's turnout is not so hot. And of course, I look over and I see BTS and they're like 4,500. I was like, man, this sucks. And I look over and I realize the stream had dropped and all of a sudden we're at 4,300. Thank you, guys. Thank you for tuning in because we know, join Dota, we're just now getting into being able to cover some of these other tournaments that Toby and his overworked self has never been able to cover. So you guys joining us for G League is really, really something special. And if you continue to spread the word that Join Dota is doing, covering the Eastern scene, we'd appreciate it. We'd appreciate it. But let's go ahead and get into this game as I welcome in my co-caster for this game. What happened to my voice? This game, it's going to be Sneyking. Sneyking, what's going on, man?
I'm good. And we're seeing the out of time first pick, and actually Bristol back and Rubik in response from Tongfu. Very snappy picks so far, and they already have their game plan, so these picks are definitely from practice. And we might see, there's Venomancer and there's Crystal Maiden available for IG if they so desire. Both heroes quite good in combination of Elder Titan.
All right, sorry, I was just clearing my throat because I'm still recovering from sickness.
Yeah, and right now, this Bristol Pack pick is really strong because another hero that is really strong against Bristol Pack is Timbersaw. And they already have Elder Titan. And unless you want to mid the Elder Titan or Timbersaw, which creates these sort of immobile heroes, it'll be really difficult for them to pick up this Timber to counter this Bristol Pack right now.
Yeah, that is a really smart way to think about it. I hadn't actually thought about it. So once again, maybe the Elder Titan first pick might actually prove to be more of a detriment than a force for good for IG. But we'll have to see as they wait on their second pick. But we had Alchemist, Visage, Slark, and Clockwork all banned out. No surprise that we're going to see CM picked up by IG. It's a good, really good combo here with Elder Titan because, any support with double nukes is going to be powerful with that Elder Titan aura. But in general, it's just a high priority support that's still left in the pool as Rubik and Bristleback was picked up by Tongfu.
And right now, the bans for IG are very open depending on what they want to do. And for Tongfu, they have a lot of options, more options than IG, because IG is forced to offlane the Elder Titan right now, while Tongfu can aggressive tri lane or sack or even farm the Bristol back. And these options are going to definitely... And I'm not sure if they have a set game plan yet, so they can do all those things that I previously said.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so I wanted to get your thoughts. We had a game yesterday where there was an Elder Titan first pick, but they still wanted to be able to grab the Timbersaw. And IG, they have this option, right? They can still grab the Timbersaw, but it forces Elder Titan to be support. I am not a big fan of that. Like, I really don't like seeing Elder Titan. But I wanted to get... It was me and Toby bantering back and forth about it. My biggest thing is he lacks any sort of disables to be able to respond. And supports that don't have disables are typically are really good at something else. Chen's really good at pushing, those sort of things. What are your thoughts, Sneyking? I want to get your thoughts on Elder Titan as a support.
When Elder Titan is run as a support, most famously ran by is run by Alliance, and EGM plays that role. And when I watch them do this Elder Titan Crystal Maiden dual support, I mean, it works out quite well because the Crystal Maiden with a heavy double nuke and lane presence sort of compromises for what Elder Titan lacks. And IG actually might do that, but I've rarely seen this Elder Titan support run by the Chinese. And I personally feel that if you want to run an Elder Titan support, you have to do with a really strong laner, another really strong laner support like a Crystal Maiden or Venomancer. And I think those two are your really only options if you want to run ETS support.
Okay, I like that. I like that. That makes perfect sense to me. Is we're going to see Klinks and Weaver banned out by IG. So going to take away some of those mid-game very, very physical DPS heroes. And Gyrocopter is taken away by Tongfu. So we saw the success of that one last game. But, I mean, Weaver's really good. I mean, both those heroes, I suppose, are decently good versus Bristleback because oftentimes they're good at positioning, being able to put themselves in a good position to be able to get in front of the Bristleback. And we've seen the success of a Clink so far in the G League, so.
And yeah, Tongfu is just after the start pick is gonna tell IG a lot on what they want to do, whether if it's a support or a carry or anything they pick. And DK ban comes out, and Nyx assassin.
So we're gonna see at the very least with the Nyx assassin, you've got that combo Rubick being able to set up an easy impale since that ability is so obnoxiously hard to land. But it also means that. Some of the high mana heroes, OD has been really successful so far in G League, I think. And that sort of mitigates that potential mid of IG. Now, it could still easily be picked up, but we're going to go for the Luna here. So, again, the Luna is picked up, but this time on the other side. And with the, the burst power of Elder Titan right now is just insane. With that aura coming out from the Elder Titan, followed up with the double nukes of Crystal Maiden, and now Luna with her Lucent Beam, and then eventually Eclipse being thrown into the equation. There is so much magic damage being thrown around in these team fights. But at the same time, Tongfu does have Bristleback. He's able to sort of mitigate some of that damage, and Nyx Assassin as well has that Spike Carapace. So we do have a little bit of our turn in that regards.
And yeah, and this Luna pick is very good from IG because there are not many other options. Gyrocopter was the other secondary option that has a high burst for the rocket barrage and the nukes rockets. And since I was banned out, Luna was a smart choice. And from right now, Tongfu, they're still quite open on what they want to do with the Nyx Assassin. But this OD, if IG does desire to pick this OD, they have a really strong Wrecking Force late game, and it is up to Tongfu to do something in the mid game, and Chen is picked up. So this will be either solo Nyx Assassin.
Yeah. Interesting. Interesting. So mid Nyx Assassin, Bristleback off lane, two supports. So Tongfu, they can still choose to pick up a late game if they feel they want to go that way, but it's doubtful up against a Luna. We're probably going to see a very aggressive mid-game-oriented hero. But we're really left in the pool. I mean, we see Weaver and Clink's banned out. Gyrocopter's also taken away. What is Tongfu, what are they looking at when it comes to options as their carry?
I mean, first of, they might actually put the Bristleback on the one and decide to offlane something else. It's entirely up to them. The choice is theirs. But the Bounty Hunter just picked up from IG, so that's going to be their sack lane. And it might be this Alliance trialing that I talked about with the Elder Titan CM plus one. We'll see what happens with the last pick from IG, and that'll tell us. But from Tongfu, on what they want to do, I'm not sure if they want to necessarily pick a carry here, because a Bristleback on the one is not necessarily terrible, because the early farm on the Bristleback, getting a Vanguard or a Hood, and then they just have him absorb all the damage for the Luna beams or the Crystal Maiden nukes, and then with the Chen sent back in heal, they'll be able to keep pushing towers and brute force, even Roshan, and just force batting games which is coming out from IG. And they ban out the Storm Spirit right now, so it may be. Maybe it is going to be a carry Bristleback.
That'll definitely be interesting. So it means we may need another offlaner, which if they're going to go for the carry Bristleback, we're presuming Timbersaw? I mean, decent. The biggest problem I see with Timbersaw is he's going to have issues with the fact that Luna picks up usually a pretty fast BKB, but he's good versus Elder Titan, Crystal Maiden. He's decent versus Bounty Hunter. If they go off lanes, what are their options then?
I mean, there are not many left for off lane. There's a Nature's Prophet, which they can pick up. Ooh. And
really? That was not in my list of heroes, of possible heroes that Tongfu was thinking of. But Viper is banned out by IG.
Yes, Viper is banned. Maybe they were thinking that Tongfu would do an aggressive trialing and short lane to Viper, or perhaps even mid it. as that might be actually a mid-Elder Titan.
Yeah, he could be. That's why Elder Titan is such a strong first pick. Not only is he just obnoxious with that aura in the mid-game and everything, but when it comes to your draft, he's very, very versatile in that regards. And Lone Druid is picked up by Tongfu. Wow. So this could still be the aggressive tri lane you were talking about with Lone Druid in the safe lane here.
But yeah, it's definitely possible. It's up to Tongfu. And this Bristol back is going to definitely be Wrecking Force regardless of what lane he's in. The early Quell does so much damage.
Well, IG, they now have to decide whether they need their mid or another support. And they're going to go for their mid? Their mid.
No, I think that's... That might... No, that is their mid, I guess.
I was about to say, because the only other option is putting Howe in mid.
Yeah, I forgot about the Bounty Hunter. No, it is going to be a... Yeah, okay, I see what they're doing. It is a mid Elder Titan. I was thinking of this, what they do. They want to Lifesteal versus Lone Druid. It's what the Chinese always like to do. And this is going to be a support Bounty Hunter. So this Bounty Hunter is going to be pretty much on the tails of the Chen. And he's just going to be running around and soaking up Chen's experience. It's going to be really interesting turnout events.
Yeah, this has to be one of the... I mean, besides DT Club and Titan, who have run some really interesting strats so far in the G League, this is... one of the more interesting drafts I've seen coming out. I mean, both teams doing some really funky things with their lanes.
And honestly, this Bounty Hunter pickup, it's going to prevent Tongfu from ever smoke ganking the two solos lanes, and which in effect is really good for them because they can't have YYF die early. And as we saw what happened last game, Elder Titan dying off early, not having any farm or any experiences is very detrimental to them. And we see the boots first coming out from Banana. Yeah, he's just going to try to wreak havoc on the Chen.
All right, guys. Well, let's go ahead. Before we see any action, let's go over who's playing what as we're going to go ahead and keep an eye on Banana and where he places those wards. We got Faith is going to be on the Crystal main. Howe is on the Luna. Ferrari playing the Lifestealer mid. YYF is going to be Elder Titan, and Banana is on the Bounty Hunter, is currently searching for the enemy heroes and seeing if he can place some good ward placement. Zhao is going to be on your lone Druid. ZSMJ is on the Chen. Kabu is on the Bristleback. San Shang is on the Rubik. And Mu is going to be your Nyx Assassin. So we saw him go ahead and place that ward blocking the pull for now. And possibly, all right, we're going to go for the medium camp. Instead of the hard camp, I mean, why would you go for the medium camp here over the hard camp?
The medium camp is just generally something you farm after the a hard camp. And even if you block the medium camp, there's still other ways. I mean, block the hard camp, excuse me. There are other ways to get the big creep. And you just jungle closer to the left and get the big creep from the left. And then you jungle the middle camp. And then it's pretty much the same. But the reason why I feel they block the middle camp, it's because it's an easy way to for the Chen to farm up the early levels that it needs.
Okay, well, I can see that. Rubik is going to go ahead and pick up the haste rune, zip around, and Banana. I mean, this is... Invis heroes are so obnoxious versus junglers. You're going to see YYF. He's going to be your offlane hero, pretty much, and we're going to have Bounty Hunter pretty much sit on the Chen and take half of the experience, which is so obnoxious. That has to be, I really think that needs to be changed. Like, Invis heroes don't get experience or something. It's just stupid. Stupid watching heroes just kind of sit in there. He's going to rotate between mid and the jungle, it looks like.
And yeah, the lanes right now, there's a very clear advantage for IG with the Lifestealer mid. That's definitely going to beat the Nyx Assassin. And this Banana, it's just... harassing both the jungle and mid lane at the same time.
Yeah, you see that Hellbear? He was just spamming out clap, making sure Ferrari couldn't come forward. He was just like giving him the warning. He was like, you come forward, this clap will land. Your poor little melee hero being blocked out by a Hellbear smasher. But you're right. Oh, man. Banana barely missing out on the opportunity to pick off the courier because of his rotation mid and his harassment onto Mu. He misses that one. So the bottle is picked up on Nyx Assassin. And that's awesome for him. Meanwhile, YYF is going to have A little bit disconcerting time at first top against blood. The Lone Druid. Oh no, I missed it.
That was my
life
wow.
Goes down. Conversion. How did that happen? Like he just got the impale clap and that was enough?
Impale clap and the body back from the Hellbear Smasher. Okay. I'm really surprised actually Farai died that quickly. His life steal is a quite tanky hero and
yeah,
he even has a stout shield.
I was not expecting the kill to be mid. Like if anything, I was expecting Nani Hunter maybe gets up level 3, level 4. And then maybe you'll see a kill on Moo of anybody, but Ferrari is going down. That's a big pickup for Moo. So nicely done. Apologize for missing that as I was trying to bring up the chat. Chat is so important to me.
ZSMJ is countering this middle camp warrior, which is good. He's going to be able to start actually getting levels. Right now, he's still sitting at zero experience.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
What happened to the... It's still there. Why didn't he kill the other help? Oh, that's right, because he used the Hellbear to throw it mid, so... Him by himself wasn't really able to clear the smaller guy. Okay.
Yeah, he wasn't. The Hellbear Smasher.
We've got two we've got two heroes that are doing like nothing except for trying to harass heroes. Like Chen's not actually jungling, and Bounty Hunter, because Chen isn't actually jungling, Bounty Hunter isn't really doing anything either. This is silly.
And we see Kabu trying to pull away the bottom camp as Faith connected the poles. And he's unsuccessful, and he didn't actually end up leeching any experience, and he just got the third experience right there. But Kapu is very underleveled right now, and Faith is level 3, and he's looking to gank towards mid of the rotation. And Mu does have boots, but the open wounds coming out from him might prove to be really deadly.
Yeah, here comes, and unfortunately the impale does not go off in time. Banana's going to join as well. Spike Hairbase doing some serious work there, and he may be able to get out. In fact, he will. Really unfortunate. Spike Carapace proving to just be too powerful against the three-man gang.
Yeah, that double summon from the impale was very good from Mu as well. And I actually was surprised that he even got a double stun from that angle.
Yeah, look at the counter ward being thrown down very, very early. Meanwhile, Banana's going to be camping the runes, so... Mu should be able to have the heads up. Look at him. They're camping on top of the room because they know Banana is sitting there, and they actually do get the illusion up on Mu. So nicely done. Camping it, trying to body block the rune almost.
Dire's
Banana is just,
is
I mean, without level 2 at the very least, like, I'm not really sure how successful Bounty Hunter is supposed to be ganking. Like, at the very least, Janata gives you a little bit of burst damage, but also that's slow. But with yeah. I mean, I would expect him to pick up level 2 in lane before he rotates out. That's kind of what I would expect, but...
Pretty much the idea of the Bounty Hunter was just prevent the Chen from doing much early game and have Ferrari just wreak havoc in this mid lane, because Lifesteal versus Nyx Assassin is a very skewed matchup, but unfortunately for Tongfu, they got it.
YYF falls. So good rotation once again. Was the smoke used for that?
No, he was just a quick lift into stomp. This is a good rotation coming out from ZSMJ, and I believe he walked on the bottom part of the path, so it dodged the ward right there. But going back to the mid lane, yeah, Lifestealer is supposed to definitely win versus Nyx Assassin. It's just that early death that set Ferrari really back right now, and he only has 15 CS while the Nyx Assassin has 21. And generally in this matchup, when you see this matchup being played, it's usually Lifestealer has 35 CS at this point in the game, and while Nyx Assassin has around 15.
Yeah, this is quite the switch up. Meanwhile, top, maybe Banana in the middle of everybody, kind of scaring me there. But at the very least, IG farming really, really well with their Luna. So if the Bounty Hunter rotation isn't really proving to be that successful, I mean, ZSMJ has cracked level 2 finally, and he was obviously a big force in being able to pick up that first blood early in middle and has now rotated top as well. So this Bounty Hunter is not really proving to be successful, but at the very least, Tao is getting tons of free farm at bottom lane.
And yeah, and finally Kabu is going to be able to pick up a few experience. He's going to hit level 4 off of this, and Chen is bottom lane, and we see a TP come out from Rubik. They're going to smoke gank possibly around on Hao. But how is it is level 6, so the Eclipse might prove to be too much for Tongfu to handle.
Yeah, and this is definitely dangerous. So with only one creep, that Centaur is going to have to do some serious tanking when that Eclipse goes off for them.
And
okay, they're
going to go to mid instead. And
So there goes the Impale leading. Unfortunately, Sansheng not close enough. No, he does get the telekinesis off just in time, and it will be successful in being able to pick off the Lifestealer. Nice gank. I really thought that we were going to see the Rage come out before telekinesis, but apparently it was just barely in time.
Yeah, it was a level 4 Impale, and it was pretty much a 3-second stun, so they had a lot of time for that telekinesis. It seemed it was cutting it quite close.
Yeah. Look at that little dragon. Little dragon courier. He's going to be bringing the hand minus recipe over to Luna. So lane's not going so well. How's the only one with farm? So he's going to turn that into even more farm with the hand of minus pickup. And as soon as he gets to the side chop, oh no, unfortunately. Move with his rotation over. I think they're really hoping to be able to pick off Hao, but they content themselves with a Crystal Maiden pickoff.
And yeah, Hao himself is going for a hand of Midas, and he's going to get it right now.
Yeah. Well, what I really love about Bristleback and offlane, it's been countered, which is really well done by IG. But even if he's unable, even if he's in a really bad lane where he can't seem to pick up much experience, he still has Ancient Stacking, which you see there's a double stack right now. The counter ward has blocked his attempts after that.
But and we see from top lane engagement and Lifestealer is actually able to take down Chen. And the bear is going to survive. But
yeah. So they finally got a Infest Bounty Hunter. You know, I don't think I missed. I might have missed one kill last game. I have missed, like, the beginning of every single kill so far. All right. Time to get serious.
No worries. And Mu is scouting out Hao, and Hao actually sees him. So this gank won't be successful.
Yeah, Illusion's being able to spy that one out, but still, Hao is definitely feeling the pressure. I mean, he's trying to pull for himself right now just so he can bring the lane far enough back, because even Bristleback is pretty scary right now. Being level 6, now has Power Tread, so he's decently tanky.
Yeah, and the great part about having Lone Druid on your 1 is the fact that you get bear form at level 6, and the hero becomes nearly impossible to kill.
Yeah.
And then so you can do this thing, cute needy tricks where you can have your supports leave the lane and still be fine. But for squishy Luna, on the other hand, it's definitely not the same case. And you see definitely Hao is feeling the pressure. He's just staying back and not even be able to see us under his tower.
Well, maybe we'll see another Bounty Hunter rotating into mid. They can infest over into that lane to see if they can pick it off. But Mu, he's just content with moving along the jungle. He still has another Vendetta if he wants to.
Yeah. The needy trick about what Mu is doing is that he's completely not showing himself on the map. So both middle lane and bottom lane have to be played passive because they get unsure where Mu is ganking. And we see the Infested Bounty Hunter right now on bananas. And he's rotating to the top lane, expecting to push.
I think he knows because of this ward near the rune at top. They see enough to be able to realize, all right, they already did the Bounty Hunter invis infest gank once. We don't see them in mid. That's got to be what's happening. And so we see Mu rotate over to top. He's sitting in Viz right now. In
Radiant's
his Vendetta.
Bottom tower is under attack.
Looking at YY off pretty hard. Thinking about it. Vendetta's going to run out too. There he goes. He goes on YYF. Easy kill for him though with the bear. Should be enough. No, Chen does a low amount of damage with his nuke. And now Chen's in trouble. He's going to go down. YYF trying to get away from the impale. Trying to potion up in time. Now Zhao, he's in a little bit of trouble trying to get gone up. But here comes Kabu. IG, I don't know if this is really going to go out well. The Bristleback is just going to tear heroes up as Rudik finally does pick up the Elder Titan, but now Ferrari, he's in trouble. Kabu trying to run away. Hao, maybe thinking about his ultimate, but no. Zhao, barely getting away from Banana his time, and Banana's going to fall as well. This is just a disaster for IG, as now Hao falls on top of that Tongfu. Not losing a single hero, except, no wait, they lost somebody, right? They lost the Chen.
They lost the Chen, yeah.
Yeah, and Chen for 4? Yeah.
And this is where Bristleback comes into play. The fact that the hero does not need any amount of gold, and just simply experience to wreck havoc on enemy team, as we saw. Bristleback was level 7 with just treads only and magic stick. Came in level 7, went out as level 9 with 2 kills and 2 assists. It just, this hero is just so great at these early engagements without anything.
Yeah, I mean, it feels like Kabu was just, this time he was like, you know what? Last game was really, really bad game for me. I kind of threw it, guys. this time I am going to carry you to victory. He's sitting a 2-0-2 as the offlane with treads and another 1,100 gold. We could see a very, very early Vanguard if he wants. Even after the treads, that's still really good timing for Vanguard. So he is just farmed to the max for an offlane as we see Mu sitting very patiently. Oh, no. Did you get disconnected?
No. Right. But right now, YYF has gone on top, and he's most certainly going to go down. And Faith actually is... No, he's going to survive. But a TP outcome from the Bounty Hunter from Bananas would have infested Lifestealer. But a Tongfu is going to be able to escape successfully. And Luna, on the other hand, talking back to the earlier engagement at top lane, he didn't actually release the Eclipse because there's a bear and Bristol back. The hero, those two things are virtually impossible to kill. And especially when you're splitting up the Luna beams on evenly onto the two, you're not going to get either or killed. And that's why she didn't use it earlier.
Well, guys, we are back. We showed the Chinese stream for a little bit just to put something up there. But unfortunately, again, the Perfect World servers and the great Chinese wall, firewall, is proven to wreak havoc on the stream. But we're back in the game. Hopefully, we don't get another DC. There's not much we can do about it, unfortunately. It's just connecting to these games are always a trial. Kabu is actually not going to be going. I'm not sure if you mentioned this, but he's going to be going for a mech over the early Vanguard.
And this is actually very good because the Chen has such a terrible start, so he was not going to be able to pick up a timely fashion mech in any time. Right. And actually, he's going to get gone on top with the Lifestealer bomb, and he's definitely going to go down.
Just business, nothing personal.
If only Banana was level 6 right now. They'd be getting those track golds, but they're going to go for another one. Chen actually spied it out, though, with a Centaur. So they know what's happening, and they should be aware of it in mid. Zhao's playing very, very
Radiant's
passive.
Bottom tower is under attack.
Even though he has a counter ward sitting there for him.
Yeah, they're just going to rotate to the bottom lane because they know that Banana is inside their jungle. So the jungle is just not a safe lane to farm in.
Yeah. He's giving himself an escape route. When they come over from behind, he's going to run right. And he does see
Radiant's
them run through
bottom
mid
tower
because
is under
of the counter
attack
ward. And they're going to be able to pick up
Radiant's
a tier 1 tower, maybe.
Fortified.
As we see YYF
Dire's
is going to start teleporting
is
in.
Under attack.
They may catch out. Banana sees him. Sancheng, you're gone. You're gone. Faith is probably going to trade his life. Impale dodges it. Nicely done. He's still going to die to Lone Druid. But now Mu is in trouble. He's going to get gone on Shuriken. Not going to go up in time. And Mu
Radiant's
successfully teleports out. Meanwhile, Luna does pick up the Bristle back. So with that level 2 ultimate, successfully picks up that one. And they're going to get the deny on tier 1 tower at bottom. So overall, a really good exchange there for IG, making up a little bit for that top, that terrible,
Radiant's
terrible
bottom
team fight.
Tower has been
yeah,
denied.
But I feel that IG is actually on quite a bit of a timer right now, because once Lundry picks up that Radiance that he's looking for, which is
Radiant's
looking to be roughly about
attack
a 19 to 20 minute Radiance, it's going to be really scary for IG to do anything, because that Radiance burn on those squishies, Bounty Hunter, Crystal Maiden, and Luna are going to be too much for them to handle. And then from the Quo spam from the Bristol back, even more AoE nukes coming out from Tongfu. It's going to be really it's just too difficult for IG to fight at all. So they're going to have to result in some sort of Wrath Dota farm with the Lifestealer and Bounty Hunter.
Yeah, I mean, I think that they really want a BKB up before they... Because I think you're right. They should be trying to push in a little bit, try and take some tier 1s before that Radiance is up. At least get them ahead a little bit in gold, or catch up, I should say, a little bit in gold before the Radiance is online and Tongfu's that big, scary mid-game force. But unfortunately, Luna just does not have enough farm to be able to pick up a really fast BKB. And that makes it
Dire's
really dangerous.
Top tower
the very least,
attack.
He has high levels. Meanwhile, we see... Kabu right now, he's clearing through an ancient stack that Rubik has been gracious enough to be able to help out with, and that means that a mech is going to be online, and I think that kind of, I mean,
Dire's
maybe the Radiance
is
enough, but
attack.
The mech, I feel, is just enough to push them in the winning edge for team fights right now.
Yeah, they're guaranteed to win team fights right now, especially with the Chen heal as well. So this Bristol back actually says 1,000 health, but his effective HP is probably near the 2,500s.
Yeah, that's true. Move pushing very, very aggressively. We also got to mention that he picked up a Blink Dagger, so now we've got initiation online for Tongfu, which is really, really big. It's something they were kind of lacking. They're big tanky heroes, but they didn't quite have the initiation besides Vendetta, and that's always a very risky form of initiation. may get caught out. Banana spies Zhao, but Zhao, he knows exactly what's up. He's playing very, very passive. He's only farming with his bear. He's making sure his hero stays in the tier one tower. He may go forward and try and bait this out as we see a rotation from Tongfu. They got him! No, the dust barely catching out Banana, and Ferrari's like, see you later, buddy. He infests out and runs away immediately. So good rotation by Tongfu. That dust was barely hitting that bounty hunter. I can't believe it stretched out that far. Rubik actually has infest. He's gonna jump inside the centaur, see if he can get some sort of initiation, pop out, telekinesis a hero,
Radiant's
catch him out by surprise.
Yeah, this is gonna be really cute play. The centaur's lift, and then Radiant's you would have the centaur stun to follow up after.
Yeah, imagine the surprise on Ferrari's face when he gets an instant telekinesis and then the follow-up stuns. This is gonna be hilarious to watch. I just really hope it works.
Yeah, and the hero that they really want to have to get picked off from the start is Crystal Maiden. Without Crystal Maiden's double nukes, they're gonna have a really rough time fighting this.
And they're running forward pretty aggressively.
Yeah,
they
but Tongfu, yeah, they don't. They're just trying to sort of bluff Tongfu, realizing. Making Tongfu just back up, because Tongfu right now, they don't want to fight either. The bear is very close to the Radiant. In fact, it's going to pick up the Relic right now, and it's only 800 away from the Radiance. They're just simply buying time for their carries to farm, but I feel that the Radiance on the bear is going to be a much more significant pickup than the BKB pickup on Luna.
Well, they're going to try and contest this tier 1 tower push coming out from, again, Faith coming into play. Just being able to freeze up the bear. They're going to try to beat it up. They won't be able to take it. But at the very least, they give Tongfu a little bit of warning that that tier 1 tower is not going to go down without a fight right now. Kaboo trying to go on Ferrari. This is the physical damage. Just so dangerous versus Lifestealer. He almost even picked him up there, and that was a very early teleport. Meanwhile, mid, Crystal Maiden does finally get picked off. Did they do it? I think they finally pulled off the infest jump out of the centaur. But it didn't kill the centaur, or is that a different one?
It doesn't kill the centaur.
Okay.
If it's a friendly infest, it will not kill any.
Yeah.
Radiant structures
are
fortified.
I'm so sad I missed that. I was busy watching Bristleback almost kill Lifestealer.
Radiant's this Bristleback just picked up a vitality booster and is meching his team, so this is going to be an easy tower for them. And they might decide to do Roshan because the Radiance is online. Fallen. This 19 minute Radiance timing is going to be very devastating for IG, because right now Tongfu can do two things. They can decide to do Roshan and then proceed to push down the remaining tier 2 towers, or they can just simply sit back and farm and then just simply play the reaction game with the blink dagger on Nyx Assassin. And actually a Rubik infest bomb coming out from Tongfu.
Oh, look at this. The double infest bomb. Uh-huh. Both invis heroes, both with infest units, walk right past each other. YYF is done, though. Telekinesis, follow-up stun, and that's going to be a very, very dead Elder type. So good gank, and here comes the turnaround. Banana's like, wait, we just passed them. What happened? Oh, man. This is quite the trolley game. Hao is pushing in aggressively atop. He does have his BKB, but he knows there's still not much, especially against that early lone druid. Big tank hero. Oh no, Faith, he's going to go down. The blink dagger initiation. That's what we're talking about. Very, very powerful. And Luna actually cancels her TP, so that's going to be a tier 2 and probably a tier 3 push with that TP cancel.
Yeah, Luna needs to start running back right now. And Tongfu. Yeah, they're just going to sit back and continue to farm or possibly do Roshan. It's entirely up to them what they want to do at this point. They have complete control of the game pace, and Nyx Assassin picks up a 4-staff. And this Nyx Assassin is so far in this game. You rarely would see these three items, Blink Dagger, 4-staff, and Mana Boots before 20-minute mark.
Yeah, I mean, even on a mid Nyx Assassin, that's just kind of a crazy amount of farm. And it all comes back to that first blood. Like, that's what it all comes back to. Them being able to successfully pick off the Lifestealer gave Moon such a huge advantage in lane. He was able to pick up a lot of CS, and he turned that into very early rotations, successful rotations. And that's going to be an early Roche. With the Bristleback being able to provide that minus armor, Roshan does not stand a chance. Faith, going to catch out Mu here, but I don't think they really have enough follow-up. Nobody's really in line. How? Trying to get close, but unfortunately, Nyx Assassin just runs away, but they do buy themselves a little bit more time. They almost have the armlet up on Lifestealer.
And this is the death ball push that I talked about earlier, and Tongfu is just gonna brute force these remaining two tier twos, and that's gonna give them a little bit more gold. And Kabu currently has 2 grand saved up, so he might go for the heart, or he might go for another hood or defiance or another just tank items. There's a lot of options for him. He can't even go for blade mail just to reflect the damage.
Yeah, I kind of like the same idea that Clockwork had last game. Up against the Elder Titan and any sort of spam, go ahead and pick up the pipe and
Radiant's bottom
just go
tower
and
has
it
fallen.
Really helps out your early tier 3 pushes. But I suppose they have a lone druid, so they don't really depend on creeps at all. Ferrari in a little bit of trouble here. Telekinesis follow up. Ferrari looking to get the infest, and he does successfully just before he gets bursted down. So nicely done. He might not be all right, though. That creep is going to go into deny range very, very quickly. He's going to have to... Oh, okay. Or burst down everything. I thought they were going to let the creeps put that... just let the creep equilibrium kind of, you know, push the creep into deny range, but...
Yeah. That was quite a weird play from Sashang. I'm confused on why he did that as well.
It was so close, too, and he's just like, nope, Fate Bolt. Denied.
Yeah, and Infest is going to be down now, so you can't do the cute little Infest bomb on the channel to Nyx Assassin, as we saw earlier. But Nyx Assassin picks up a Vitality Booster as well, just for the health aspect, just to tank up a little bit.
Radiant's top tower is
yeah,
under
Nyx
attack.
Assassins have been doing that lately. It runs into the Elder Titan and force staffs himself forward to see if he can catch out Elder Titan while he's stunned, just to see if maybe he was between a Tier 2 and Tier 3. But they're going to be able to take a tier 2 on
Radiant's
top of that.
Who
is now
fallen.
Going for the Halberd. He's got a Sange right now. So that's going to be another decent tanking item. He'll be able to really fight the Lifestealer. Once he has that evasion, he'll be able to just stand, fight Lifestealer with all his physical damage. Ferrari going to have to pop. Make sure Root. Oh, first hit Root, and Ferrari's done
Radiant's
for. He's going to lose his rage. Telekinesis follow up, and he is dead. How unfortunate is that? I really don't think a second hit was going to come out from the bear. That was one and only hit that was going to land
Radiant's
from the bear, and he does successfully contangle.
And yeah, if you're in Ferrari's situation, especially being this far behind, it's one of the most enraging things you can possibly.
Yeah, at this point in time, you're just ready to rage call the GG, but. That may happen anyway as the tier 3 is being pressured. Elder Titan, he's going to throw his ultimate, going to do a minimal amount of damage. All the heroes dodge
Radiant's
it.
Top tower
and
is
no
under
initiation
attack.
From IG. They're just kind of giving this Radiant one up. Faith comes forward, but he's going to get nuked down. And IG just can't really do anything about
Radiant's
this.
Top tower has
frankly, I'm a little bit surprised how he's here at all. I mean,
tower is under attack.
I expect him almost to just split push because there goes the ultimate, but still not going to do much. Tongfu walk away even though they don't necessarily need to. They're just so tanky. Rax is going to fall very, very soon. Ferrari, he's going to start trying to beat up the bear here. Nice stomp. That was a beautiful play, but they just can't seem to have any follow-up at all. With the Eclipse down, all of their damage is gone. And is that just me, or was
Radiant's
that like a gigantic infest
fallen.
Lead? On the YYF. Oh, how? He's done for. Mu once again with the initiation. The BKB does not go off in time. They're going to be dead. Ferrari going to see if he can finally pick off Zhao, but again, he has the Aegis. Even if you do pick him up, he's trying to eat the bear. The bear does fall finally. Hao with the buyback coming back into play, but he doesn't have Eclipse. They just don't have enough damage. Zhao does finally fall. He's going to lose his bear. He doesn't have another one, too. 80 seconds until that. Moves in a little bit of trouble. This bear is definitely done. This is the problem with Aegis up on Zhao. It's just not that successful. Faith is going to be able to chase him. Frostbite's going to go out. And that is a big team fight. Kabu still trying to pop out before he goes down. He will be able to successfully do so. Bristleback has just proven to be too successful. Oh, the slow barely gets Hao out of range. And now Kabu turning, trying to kill YYF, but he's going to fall. Complete team wipe for Tongfu. Even though they got tier 3, they got Rax, they're still very, very far ahead. This is much like last game for IG. Tongfu made some sort of stance, were able to wipe the other team, but again, it just the Rax, it feels like Tongfu is just so far ahead, almost 14,000 gold lead. So not quite the same as the 20,000 gold lead we saw from last game, but still, Tongfu very much still in the driver's seat of this game.
Yeah, indeed, and that team fight win was not as good as the team because they forced a buyback from Hao, and he actually didn't get much of any gold from that fight at all, and he's still having the buyback debuff and can't get any gold from the farm that he's getting in the base right now. And right now, Roshan will not be up for another couple minutes, so Tongfu is just going to pick up that Assault Cuirass on the bear and just contently farm themselves the next couple minutes and then just do another death push. And perhaps they'll maybe be on the Bristol back this time, because the Bristol back end just charge in and just absorb all the damage. And if you don't force focus the Bristol back, he's going to wreck and force with the goo and the Quail Spray onto your rest of your team. So it's just a double-edged sword for IG to deal with.
Well, we're going to see another Infest Bomb. IG, they really need to continue picking off heroes before Tongfu start grouping up. As you said, just pick up the AC, grab Roshan, and then it's pretty much a guaranteed win after that. So IG really need to find some pickoffs. Unfortunately, Banana is just looking at the wrong place. Nobody is in the jungle right now. As now, yep, and there goes the AC on Lone Druid, and we're going to see a smoke up by Tongfu. They know the only chance they could lose this game is just getting picked off repeatedly. So if they group up and see if they can maybe find a pickoff of their own, they can easily end the game right now.
Yeah, there's no buyback from Hao. So if they get a kill on Hao, it's pretty much going to be a guaranteed double racks.
Yeah, nobody else has buyback either due to gold reasons on IG. Closest one is going to be Lifestealer. He will be able to have it up in time for the team fight. So at least they have that. SNY is actually picked up by Bristleback.
Yeah, it's a common item on Bristleback. It makes the hero very fast and tanky, and this hero is actually near 500 max movement speed from the stacks from Quell when he decide to use them.
You know, I was kind of expecting the Halberd just because they're tanky enough, they know they're going to be able to live long enough through the Lifestealer and the Luna, BKB, and the Rage. So I figured, you know, I would just wait for that to go down. Afterwards, they pop all their big things, Eclipse and that sort of thing. You're still tanky enough to live, maybe you'll be a little low. And then you can just halberd up the Luna or the Lifestealer. Your choice, really. But
yeah.
SNY is still really, really strong at Bristleback, as you said.
Yeah, and Tongfu just...
Look at that gank on the bear. Four staff it away. Nicely done by San Shang. They just popped everything to see if they can kill the bear. Very, very fast gank. And it would have been on cooldown for another 10 seconds. But Lone Druid will have two bears for the next fight.
And yeah, just... Tongfu, I'm not sure if they want to necessarily brute force this before next Roshan is up. And there's really no reason for them to do that because they have the whole map to farm right now. And right now, IG is limited into their base. The only thing that get to farm is the creeps that come into their base.
These small things like Hao split pushing, he's trying to push out this lane because they're feeling the constant pressure, but at the same time, it's very, very dangerous. Look at him, he's immediately teleporting. No one's actually really close to him. Mu was rotating over. He knows that he can just barely push out of the base, try and relieve some of that pressure, and immediately go back because he knows Mu is going to be on top of him in very, very short fashion.
Yeah, I mean, this is mainly due to the lack of vision as well coming out from IG. They don't have a single ward outside their base right now, and Tongfu doesn't even have a gem, so they can actually place these wards and have free vision, but they just don't have the opportunity to step outside and actually place them.
Yeah, well, we're waiting on Tongfu right now. Roshan gonna be up in a minute and a half, so that's gonna be your next big play. Now IG, they have to go out, smoke out, and try and contest Roshan, correct?
I mean, contesting Roshan is honestly, yeah, the only thing they can really, that's left for them to do. And if they lose the Roshan fight, it's going to be similar to last game. It's just going to be a GG call out, and they actually going to probably get a pick on Sasheng here. But Sasheng should have seen that invis.
Yeah, maybe he didn't. Maybe Nighttime has proven too powerful. Four staff, and now the Ghost Scepter away may give him enough time to be able to do some work. There goes another four staff away by ZSMJ, and he's actually going to be able to get out. Chen teleports him out. Mu now turning around. Hao popping his ultimate. They really want something here, but Kabu, he's just taking up so much damage with his Bristleback. He's going to start turning because here comes the rest of his team. YYF, nice dump. Keeping the Zhao in place for now. The ultimate's going to be able to go out. That's going to be a huge amount of damage. Crystal Maiden, Faith, locking him down with his ultimate. Mu, he's got to get out. This is just a disaster for Tongfu. Heroes are falling left and right. Telekinesis is perfectly timed. Mu's going to turn around with the Chen TP and get a nice little stun. San Shang, open wounds. He's going to go down here. He just can't escape. Ghost Scepter's going to give him a little bit of time. But Mu, careful, buddy. You got to get out of there. You've already lost so many heroes. They're going to go for Roshan. Top is pushing in right now, but it is definitely worth possibly losing a tier 4 in order to pick up Roche. This is their only attempt at a comeback here, is going all in on the Roche and being able to pick that one up. Moo sitting on the side. He gets tracked, though. Banana trying to fight him. May get popped here. We don't have any involved. Oh, the Vendetta goes out. And now Gem is lost. They still have Vision. They may still be able to pick up Roshan. Here comes the Lone Druid. It's going to be close, but they have Aegis. They're going to be able to snag it just in time. My goodness, the damage just suddenly faltered. Spirit Baron, a little bit of trouble. Ferrari so low. How? Is stunned up. He still has the Aegis. He's going to wait till he dies to be able to pop the BKB and try and turn, but he's just surrounded. There's no way he's getting out of this one, I fear. He could pop BKB, maybe attempt at some sort of team fight, but no. He's done for. He knows it. He doesn't even lose a BKB charge just because he knows with the Spirit Bear, there's just no way he can fight that.
Yeah, and Hal does have buyback right now. Well, I mean, Zoe, excuse me. But if he uses this, this will lose all the advantage he got from winning that team fight and Roshan. And Tongfu's just going to brute force this, and I don't see another option. He has to buy out.
Yep, he's going to have to lose all of that gold that he saved up. There goes the buyback, and Tongfu immediately back up a little bit, though I'm sure they're going to continue their push. No reason not to, it feels like, at this point, especially with the buyback on cooldown. Do they have any big items coming their way anytime soon? I don't think so.
No, they don't. But they backed up because Zoe actually had used buyout there as well to get the to get there in time. He's on cooldown as well, so he's just going to farm the whole map. I mean, there's really no need to necessarily to push into IG right now, especially with the recent buyout on Luna. They can simply starve them out, so to speak, because they do have dual cores with the Lone Druid Emperor still back. They have a lot more slots to be filled up, and they really need a gem pickup, though, I feel, from Tongfu. And the gem they got picked up from IG earlier. So gem will prevent the Lifestealer pickup that's been happening to the two supports, and they have four staffs as well, so it's very difficult to catch up to them.
Yeah, we saw last time they had the jump on Sun Sheng, but he still lived for a rather long time because of Ghost Scepters and four staffs. So Tongfu definitely able to kite around the Lifestealer as much as they want. And I can't believe this. Banana, he's just now popping level 11. He's just now getting that second level of track. Has pretty much been. I mean, the Infest Ganks, besides him being pretty much this this free ride for Lifestealer, he has pretty much been a non-factor. Like, you get the Invis pop out, and then his job is done.
Yeah, I mean, they went for a huge strategy focus on having a good start on the Lifestealer with the Bounty Hunters chasing out the Chen. I mean, it's going back to the first one once again, just really hurt their game plan. And it's reflecting up on them right now. Their racks in complete lockdown.
Yeah, well, we're going to have a number of buybacks still up. A Lifestealer, Elder Titan, both have buybacks. Unfortunately, Luna is still down for another 3.5 minutes. So the timing, maybe push in 2 minutes for Tongfu. That means you know you're going to have a buyback in case things go horrible on the Lone Druid. But it's still, if you win the team fight, you know that Luna doesn't have a buyback. Is that Tongfu's plan here?
No, Tongfu is just going to continually farm the whole map. I mean, it's going to take another Bounty Hunter Lifestealer bomb and catch the supports out in order for them to do anything. But the thing is, it's just they have complete vision of their whole base right now. Outside their base, Tongfu, that is. So they're sticking together. So it's very hard in order for them to do that, while the bear is just safely farming on the whole other side of the map.
Yeah. So I wanted to get your thoughts on what does Nyx Assassin go this late in the game? Does he go and maybe go something like an Ethereal Blade with the Ghost Scepter, because he's got both mobility items. He's got everything a Nyx Assassin really needs except for level 16. What do you go this late in the game as a Nyx Assassin?
I mean, there are essentially two options. You can go for the Ethereal Blade to either save your teammate or disable the Lifestealer or Luna from possibly attacking, or you can go for the Sheepstick route and then just lock down the enemy carry. I mean, essentially, you just want to prevent them from doing any output of damage, and both will do that job, both items.
Well, he's going to wander around, Vendetta up, and double damage, but of course, he's not going to find anybody because as you've been saying, IG are just locked inside their base. And we see that gold lead going down. I mean, it's been about 5 minutes, and you can see it has just been down, 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 down to the 12,000 gold lead right now for Tongfu. Experience lead actually going the way of IG, though that's not going to be the case in another minute, as Tongfu are seriously out-farming IG.
And Tongfu, yeah, it's pretty evident what Tongfu's game plan is. They're stacking Ancient with the Chen as well. So they acknowledge that they don't need to push, and they're just going to safely farm the whole map and just wait for the next Roshan to end the game.
Smart play. I mean, I can't say that I would have the same patience versus a Luna, but you're absolutely right. They are really just outclassing IG when it comes to farm. You're soon going to have the heart up on Bristleback. Lone Druid has another 3k on him. What else do we got? 1700 on Nyx Assassin again. Still far away from a really late game item that we're expecting. Bristleback actually going for the Basher over Heart.
Yeah, I mean, it's a very smart choice from Kabu, because there's no need to go any more health. As long as you lock down a Luna, there's not going to be any more output really coming out from IG, because all the farms coming into these lanes is being farmed by Luna. Like, everyone else is just watching behind him and watching him farm. I mean, if you take a look at the net worth right now, it evidently shows that no one on IG really has any farm. Even the lifesteal doesn't have much. He's behind the Nyx Assassin by a significant margin.
Yeah, he really is. He hasn't even broke the 10,000 mark. In fact, YYF is ahead of him in farm right now. So, unfortunate situation as we just pretty much watch these two teams farm away. And, I really like that. I really like the Basher, because it also means he can just man fight up against a Lifestealer, because he knows Lifestealer certainly isn't going to get that item anytime soon. He actually goes ahead and picks up a Halberd on Lifestealer. That's how, I mean, that is such a defensive item to have on a Lifestealer.
And Kabu actually disassembled his SNY and brought the Heaven's Halberd as well after picking up his Basher.
Nice. I think that's smart. I mean, you're beginning to lose some of your effectiveness on SNY at this point in time, right?
Yeah. So. Might as well pick up Heaven's Halberd. Plus evasion, plus disabling the enemy from dealing damage. And Basher picks up on Zhou's Bear, so they're just going to go for the lockdown permastun, and perhaps they don't even want to wait for the Roshan. They can just brute force this tower and possibly Rex.
Yeah, well, they do have enough gold for almost buybacks. I'm pretty sure after this team fight, even if it does go poorly, they'll get some hero gold off of it, and they should have enough for at least buyback on the lone druid, who's only 600 away. But I mean, they've waited this long. It kind of feels like why push it? If you've waited for this long, you might as well wait just a couple extra minutes for Roche.
Yeah, and Zoe's definitely agreeing with you. He's checking Roshan, just casually farming the enemy jungle. No big deal. Not in a rush to do anything. Just farming neutrals, you know?
Butterfly is up on Luna, and that's definitely into a big increase to her survivability versus the Bristleback and the Lone Druid, because neither one of them do have an MKB, so...
And yeah, and Faith just... It's going suicide mode. He plays this ward, and he's going to pay for it with his life. Oh,
Moo looking for it. He doesn't have Vendetta right now for the extra speed. He's just relying on the Blink Dagger in five seconds. He's still going to get it. No.
He's going to get it.
Oh, my goodness.
Wow.
Barely missing out. Moo unable to get the impale off in time. Faith, I can't believe that he just pulled that off.
Yeah, I mean, it was the track movement speed. Otherwise, Nyx Assassin would have caught up to this slow maiden.
That was crazy. You know, I really should have been checking the Chinese stream during this whole entire time, since they are like 4 or 5 minutes behind. Maybe we could have rewatched some of those actions, but that's what the production value you get from Toby. I'm still a big newbie. Of course, now we're getting to a point where now we're seeing the beginning on the Chinese stream. We're beginning to see that the whole CS thing that it's been going on for the last 5 minutes. So we're not going to switch to that now. But Roshan is up, and it is going down.
Yeah, and there's going to be cheese as well. And Kabu's going to pick up this cheese, and he's going to be really hard to beat. He's not going to die in the teamfight, let's just say. Yeah, he drops his Vitality Booster.
Roshan has
cheese,
fallen to
I presume.
Die.
Yeah, cheese on Bristleback.
Yeah, good call. I mean, if Lone Druid does somehow get targeted, even though he's got a Ghost Scepter, so it's very doubtful that he's going to die of the Forest Bear. But if he does, he'll have the Aegis. The bear will still go to work.
And Necrobook 1 is picked up by Mew. I'm not a big fan of this late game book. I mean, it's 41 minutes in. What is a Necro 1 really going to provide in a team fight?
Yeah. I mean, when you said two things, I thought Necrobook was going to be one of them. And I was thinking, you know, I just don't see the effectiveness. I mean, by the time you actually get that Necrobook 3, it's going to be like 50 minutes in. It's not really effective at that point. I mean, most of that, your push is going to become before you get Necrobook 3. So, yeah, interesting. Not sure if I agree with it, but he actually does get spied out. Track is up on him.
And just Tongfu just sitting on the cell, and they do have a smoke. So they're probably going to wait up for this track to wear off on the Nyx Assassin and then just smoke into their base. A common play at this point of the game. And then Zoe was just casually pushed up from the front and then walk into the base.
Well, we'll have to keep an eye on it.
As they push in.
This is down. So we might see it now.
Yeah, and on for the buyout status on IG, there's Elder Tyne and Luna both have buyout, and there's also the Bounty Hunter. But Banana.
He's going to get caught out as he moves forward for a track, and that is a team fight that is off to a terrible start. Buyback is up on the Bounty Hunter, though. So he will still be here for this team fight. And there it goes. He pops it. It's Tongfu. Are they still thinking about backing up? It looks like they're just not fully committed yet. There he goes. Finally, they're going to start beating on this tier 3 with the Necrobook 1 doing so much work. Are fortified. Zhao, Hao popping his ultimate. He's actually turned on Eclipse. There's a lot of units, though. And he's having a hard time target one here or another. Most of Tongfu is backing up. Nice use of Force Staff there. And they successfully get the Eclipse out of Luna without anything really lost. I mean, they didn't even take much damage. I mean, the most hero damage there was on Zhao. And he actually goes to range form, allowing Urn to be able to heal him up. So they successfully bait out an ultimate with really nothing lost at all.
Yeah. And they're just going to reset after that and go for this push because they know Luna will not have BKB and Eclipse. It's gonna this should be an easy Rax coming out from Tongfu.
Well, we're going to see more Necrobooks as ZSMJ actually goes for one on his own. I expect that out of a Chen, though. Chen's a little bit more liable to go Necrobooks. But here comes the push again from the side. A little bit of nuke damage going down. The bear is actually almost dead. He does have another one, but Ferrari's probably going to try and target that one. Start going on it. There goes the stomp. Nicely done. The bear does get cleaned up. Here comes another one. Hao, he's about to fall. Butterfly trying to do his work. He turns with the Helmet Dominator, but it's not enough lifesteal. Fake doing some decent damage with his ultimate, but there goes that ultimate. Spirit Bear has to get out. He has to get out of here. If he loses that Spirit Bear, it's going to be a trouble. Ferrari, oh, look at the damage coming out from Kabu. There goes 2-1. There goes 2. How? He's left alone to try and defend against this gigantic Tongfu team. His allies are just falling like flies. YYF and How are the only two left, and it looks like they are going to be able to take Arax. At the very least, Bristleback will be able to run forward. With the Spirit Bear down, they can't do quite as much damage. But Kabu's going to stick around for at least the melee racks. No, he wants some more. There he goes. He starts backing up. Zhao now going forward a little bit on the range racks. Kabu committing, trying to pick off Hao. He just, with so little health, he's still doing so much work. Hao, maybe going to be able to go down the stomp. Stopping Rubik just in time. Luna barely alive with 70 health, and he has to go back to the fountain. Now YYF is a little bit in trouble. Kabu with the slow, they should be able to pick him up. Mu actually finally comes in with the Blink Dagger, ran all the way across the map, and that is going to be a second set of racks. Still, Tongfu probably going to maybe reset after this as the Lifestealer is almost back up, and they don't have a Spirit Bear. They may get into a bad engagement here. Two racks down, they're going to blink away. Good escape, nobody really getting caught out as all four staffs keeping everybody alive. Sansheng maybe in a little bit of trouble. Attack. There goes the slow. They're going to try and target him. There goes the Hao activating his ultimate. Sansheng is going to die. He loses his life in exchange for the rest of Tongfu. Maybe be able to get out. Ferrari chasing down ZSMJ. He's going to fall as well. Moon looking to see an opportunity if he can maybe blink and save his ally, but he's just got to get out. Nice, four staff over the cliff. Maybe going to be able to get him. In fact, he will. How does not have his nuke up. Good escape by ZSMJ, and they only lose the Rubick out of all of that. Did he buy back? No, did he get out?
No, he got sent home. So oh, okay. Rubick didn't even go down, and I'm going down. They're going for mass necrobooks.
Mass necrobooks it is. So they lost nobody. Out of that whole entire chase, not a single hero going down. Good escape by Tongfu. I thought the sticking around for that long was a little too ballsy for my flavor, but being able to make it work, Tongfu in a serious advantage, two racks down. We could talk about gold lead, but it really just does not matter this late in the game. 25,000 lead right now.
I mean, when your Rubick has more net worth than a mid-solo lifestealer.
Yeah.
That just shows you how behind IG is and how little gold that they have.
Yeah, they just satanic. I'm presuming that's going to be the next item on Luna. I mean, you would love some more damage, but there were times in those team fights where if Hao had just had a satanic when he turned and fought, Helm of Dominator just wasn't enough lifesteal for him. So
yeah.
If he can get that up, maybe for the next push, maybe they have a chance, but it's such a gigantic mountain of gold that IG have to climb, being two racks down like this. But again, this game is so important. It'll make them 3-0. If they lose to Tongfu, they may get contested and drop down to second place if Tongfu win their last game.
Oh my goodness.
What? I hear you counting over there.
Yeah, there's four necrobooks from Tongfu. Even Lonesyard has one. I mean, yep. I'm not sure if this is necessary, but they're definitely finishing this game in style.
Yeah, this is like the ultimate, like, no hands push, popping four necrobook threes and having the bear run at the tower and the racks. Just those minions by themselves will probably be able to win the fight. So we're gonna go ahead here, since I talked about it earlier. We're gonna watch the Chinese stream a little bit as we see that replay of the engagement. They teleport away. I really thought that Rubick had gone down because I started to focus on Chen. I figured that, you know, in the middle of that eclipse ultimate, there was no way that he was going to go down. But still, and we see ZSMJ with that good four staff and instant teleport. Really smart play. Was that a water bottle?
Yeah, it was. Does it sound funny?
All of a sudden, I hear this glugging sound. I was like, what in the world? Sneaking, what's going on in your apartment? Manta is actually picked up by Luna. Do you agree with that pickup over going for a satanic?
Satanic. I mean, I personally thought that she needs survival, but she also needs output. So before, because there's only one set of racks left.
Radiance,
they're
going to
keep slow pushing. In fact, the Necrobooks are bottom lane. Takes out the bottom tier 3 tower.
Bottom tower has
and IG doesn't even react to it. I'm not sure what they're doing. The Necrobook just takes out 500 health off the racks.
Stop looking at it. I mean, the heroes don't even have to come forward necessarily. And now the Chen creeps are going to work. Nice stun coming out. Ferrari may get bursted down here before he can do much. But YYF with a really good clap may be able to save his ally. Moves chasing him. Meanwhile, Hao's in the middle of everything. He's popping his ultimate. He's trying to clear through all of these summons. He does successfully kill the Spirit Bear, but he's in trouble. Hao gonna fall. YYF, four staff trying to help him out. Ferrari, the GG call. Faith calls it, and Tongfu do successfully push this to a game 3. 1-1, we are tied up, and both teams are fighting for the pleasure of being undefeated in the group stage. IG is 2-0, Tongfu is 1-0, and guys, don't go anywhere. We will be right back with game 3 of IG versus Tongfu.